Hello students, we'll be taking up a chapter which will be fetching you around 11 to 15 marks in this examination. Okay, that is nothing but simple interest, compound interest along with the annuity, right? Like we'll be dealing with the basics now, right? What is the interest? Interest is nothing but interest. It is a compensation received by the lender of the money by the borrower on a specific sum with a specific rate and for a limited time period, right? Like we know one formula, SIS PTR by 100, okay, where P is the principal, T is the time, and R is the rate of interest. But we are not going to use this formula, we are going to just change the formula, like SIS P into R into N, where P is the principal amount, R is the rate of interest. But see here, R, what we have to do is, whenever they have given the rate of interest as 10% or 5%, or they'll be giving as 8%, whatever it might be. See, if they have given 10, we have to divide that rate of interest divided by 100. That is 10 by 100, it is 0.1. 5 by 100, it is 0.05, and 8 by 100, it is nothing but 0.08. If it is 18%, 0.18. okay, see, whenever they have given the rate of interest, we have to divide it by 100 and then we have to take the value. And one more thing we have to understand is, whenever they have given the time duration, if they have given the time in 6 years, we have to take N as 6. If they have given as 10 years, we have to take it as 10. If they have given in months, we have to be careful. Like whenever they have given like 9 months, okay. If they have given 9 months, we have to understand one thing. There is 12 months in a year. We have to convert. This formula is applicable only for the years, not for the months and not for the days and all. For that, what we have to do is, we have to convert the months into years. That is 9 by 12. We have to divide it by 12. That is nothing but 3 by 4, that is 0.75 years we have to take. If they have given like 15 months, they have given us 15 months, that is 15 by 12. 15 by 12, it is nothing but 1.25 years. Whenever they have given in the months, we have to divide it by 12 so that we can convert that time period into years. If they have given in days, they have to divide it by 365, right? Okay, that is what the basic part, that is a simple interest formula, is nothing but P into R into N. P is the principal, R is the rate of interest, and N is the time duration. Okay, like we'll go further. See here, let us assume that you have given a loan for your friend. Like he has accepted to pay you 5% interest. You have given 10,000, and after 1 year, he'll be repaying the money for you. That is 10,000, 5%, it is nothing but how much? 500 rupees, right? 500 rupees you have to. Okay, see here, at the end of the year, what will happen is, he will be paying you 10,500, right? That is 10,000 is the principal and 500 is the interest what you have to pay back, right? That is 10,000 plus 500 you'll be receiving. That is 10,500 will be calling that as the future value. Future value will be denoting by F. Future value is nothing but it is the sum total of principal and interest payable at the end of interest period. That is F is equal to P into P plus I. That is future value is principal plus interest, right? Okay. And moving further, see here, like we can just substitute the value of simple interest formula here. F is equal to P plus interest formula. Simple interest formula is P into R into N. Okay, therefore you just take the common P. If you take common, it is 1 plus Rn. Future value of simple interest direct formula is one more. We have one more, that is P into 1 plus Rn. This is all the basic things that you have already learned. That is that's why I'm a bit quick, right? Like what I'll do here is, in this session, I'll deal with all the properties of the simple interest, and then I'll take up the problems one by one, right? Okay, simple interest formula is P into R into N. Simple interest future value formula is P into 1 plus Rn. Okay, the next, going further, see, I'll take a times. See here, if they have given a question like in simple interest, if you have given a money to someone and it has doubled itself, that is two times in 5 years. Let us assume you have paid a money to someone and that money has been doubled in 5 years. Okay, like they can ask one question: in how many years the sum of the money what you have paid will become four times, right? Four times how many years? X years, right? Okay, for that you have to use a property, that is n1 by n2 is equal to t1 minus 1 divided by t2 minus 1. That is nothing but see here, like n1 is number of years in the first case and n2 is the number of years in the second case. T1 is the times in the first case and t2 is in the times in the second case. That means what? Like, see, if you take up like 5 by x is equal to 2 minus 1 divided by 4 minus 1, that is 5 by x is equal to 1 by 3, x is equal to 15 years, right? Okay, the number of years in which the sum of money becomes four times by itself, it is 15 years if it is doubling in 5 years, right? Are you getting this one? N1 by N2 is equal to T1 minus 1 divided by T2 minus 1. This is the formula, right? Okay, moving further, they'll be asking, sometimes they'll be giving you to find out the okay, see here, one question might come like this. Okay, see, what do you call, a clerk was calculating the simple interest on a certain amount, right? Like for 4 years and at 5% per annum. Are you getting this one? See, a clerk was calculating a simple interest for 4 years on a certain sum of money for 4 years at 5% per annum. Instead of taking 4 years and 5%, he has taken 6 years and 8%. Are you getting this one? See, like what he what is there in the question? A sum of money, a clerk was calculating the simple interest on a certain sum of money on for 4 years at 5% per annum, but instead of that he has taken the 6 years and 8%, and the difference in the money and the difference in the simple interest was rupees 800. 800 was the difference. While he has calculating, he has mismatched and he has exceeded 800 rupees. Then the question is, calculate the sum of money which was he was calculating, that is find the principal, right? Okay, in that case what you have to do is, see, the clerk calculated wrongly. One was the right calculation and another one was the wrong calculation, and the difference is 800. You have to understand one thing: the difference means what? The highest the highest value minus lowest value. That means what? SI minus SI, simple interest minus simple interest, is equal to 800, right? That is what P into R into N minus P into R into N is nothing but 800, right? Okay, take the second case. Since 8 into 6 will give the higher value, that's why always difference means the higher value minus lower value you have to take, otherwise you will be getting the negative value. Principal unknown, rate of interest is 0.08 into 6 years minus principal is unknown, rate of interest is 0.05 into 4 will be equal to 800, right? Okay, take the principal as common. 0.08 into 6 is 0.48 minus 0.05 into 4 is 0.2, you'll be getting 800, right? That is what, like, take the difference. P into 0.28 is equal to 800, therefore principal is 800 divided by 0.28, that is 800 divided by 0.28, you'll be getting the answer as 2857, right? Point change. Principal is nothing but 2857.14, right? This is the amount of principal what they'll be asking. See, they can give the error so many times, it has been repeated almost. If you take 10 years question paper, you can see this is a chapter where you will be getting a question based on each and every single concept. You'll be getting the questions because it will be there for 15 marks, almost 13 to 15 marks. You can expect the questions out of it, right? Okay, moving further, right? Just a moment. Okay, fine. Just I'm telling you the concepts. Afterwards, I'll take the questions in detail. Don't worry about that. One by one, I'll be sharing you the material, questions material, along with the solution will be posted on the video. Right, we will take up the compound interest. I'm not dealing with completely, don't worry about that, because since I'll take all the detailed problems I'll be taking, just I'm explaining the concept so that you can have a glance of the same. Right, like I'll take it further. Okay, see here, what about compound interest? See, the compound interest, like you'll be getting interest to the interest. Once again, see, the first year simple interest and compound interest will be same. That means what? Like if you have taken a loan for only 1 year, the value the interest what you are paying in the simple interest will be equal to the interest paid through the compound interest, right? Since after the 1 year only the complications will start. What will happen here in the compound interest? Let us assume that you have you need to pay around 800 rupees as interest in the first year, but in the second year what will happen, you have to see for the principal, let us assume 10,000 and 8% is the rate of interest. The first year you'll be paying 10,000 into 8%, that is nothing but 800, but in the second year you have to pay 800 for the see here, what will happen, this 10,000 will be automatically added with the interest, that is 800. You have to pay the interest for 10,800. Are you getting this one? 10,800. Okay, that is, see here, that is 864. See here, the thing is that you will be paying the interest not only for the principal what you have taken, but you have to pay the interest for the previous year interest as well. Okay, that means what? Like the second year interest, the first year interest will be 800 and the second year interest will be 864, since that 800 also it has fetched around 64 rupees as the interest. See here, that is what we'll just deal with the formula. Compound interest formula is P into, see here, first of all I'll deal with the future value of the compound interest. Future value is nothing but the sum total of principal and interest. The simple interest future value formula is P into 1 plus R N, P into 1 plus R N. But in compound interest what will happen, the formula for the future value will be equal to P into 1 plus R whole power N. Right, that means what? Principal into 1 plus rate of interest to the power of the years, right? Okay, therefore the compound interest formula is nothing but P minus compound interest. See, let us assume one thing, you have given a you have given a loan of rupees 25,000 to your friend and he has given 28,000, right? Loan you have given as a principal will be 25 and the future value is 28. What is the interest then? Interest is nothing but the 3000, right? Okay, the similar manner, compound interest can be calculated by future value minus principal. Future value is 28,000, what you got back, minus 25,000, that is principal. That is CI is equal to, compound interest is equal to future value minus principal. That is, you just substitute, future value formula is P into 1 plus R whole power N minus P. P take a common, P into 1 plus R whole power N minus 1. Okay, that is nothing but the compound interest formula. Okay, future value of compound interest formula is P into 1 plus R whole power N, and compound interest formula is P into 1 plus R whole power N minus 1. Right, this is the formula for the compound interest. I'll be dealing with the formulas, don't worry about that. Okay, right, see here, what you have to understand here is, whenever normally the bank will be charging the interest for year wise, but if the banks are charging the interest half yearly or monthly or quarterly, what will be the formula? Right, see here, whenever this formula will be same, that is future value for the compound interest is P into 1 plus R whole power N, and compound interest formula is P into 1 plus R whole power N minus 1. But if the interest is being charged half yearly means what? N will be 6 months, right? That's why we have to take N as 2N, and rate of interest you have to divide it, that is R by 2. Whenever it is compounded half yearly, R should be divided by 2 and N should be multiplied by 2. Whenever the compound interest is being calculated quarterly means there is 4 quarters in a year, right? That's why N will be 4N and R will be equal to R by 4, and N, and whenever the banks are calculating the interest monthly, that is compounding monthly, then what, R will be equal to R by 12 and N will be equal to 12N, right? Are you getting this one? This value you have to substitute. Don't worry, we'll take the problems based on this. Okay, going further, we'll be taking the difference part. See, the formula for the difference you have to just understand. See here, like the difference between the simple interest and compound interest for the first year. Difference, that means what? Difference is nothing but compound interest minus simple interest. Difference between the first year is always zero. And difference between simple interest and compound interest for 2 years. I'll take 1 year, this is 2 years. 2 years formula difference is compound interest minus simple interest is equal to, we have two formulas. One is PR square and another formula, compound interest is equal to, compound interest minus simple interest is equal to simple interest into R divided by 2. Yes, this is the formula which I have only derived. That is compound interest minus simple interest for the 2 years difference is nothing but simple interest into rate of interest divided by 2. If you calculate this also, you'll be getting the difference value. And the third question, third one, if the difference is for 3 years, if they have given the difference for 3 years, compound interest minus simple interest is equal to PR square into R plus 2. R plus 2 or R plus 3? R plus 3. Okay, PR square into R plus 2. Just a moment, I'll just reconfirm it.